Good evening. The deaths of 33 Victorians have now been linked to 000 delays. A damning new report reveals some emergency calls were going unanswered for more than an hour. The Emergency Services Minister has apologised, but for some families, it's too late. Emily Rice has the story.
The report into Victoria's emergency call service exposes deep failings, with 33 deaths associated with 000 and ambulance delays.
I am, of course, deeply sorry for the loss, your trauma, your grief.
The review by the Inspector General for Emergency Management found that between last September and the end of May this year, the performance of the emergency call taker was unacceptable.
There was no doubt that Esther was in crisis.
14-year-old Alicia Hussein died in October from an asthma attack while waiting more than 15 minutes for a 000 call to connect. Her grieving mother, Jasmine, read the report this afternoon.
It took 33 deaths, including my daughter, for this to happen, like this day to actually come. It's probably the first time I feel like I've heard a sincere apology.
000 calls are supposed to be answered within 5 seconds. On January 14, one caller waited 1 hour and 15 minutes for someone to pick up. A week later, less than 13% of calls were answered in time.
We were having up to 4,000 calls a day in January, which is almost double what you would regularly expect.
Among the major contributors to the crisis were resource failures. Esther did not have enough ambulance call takers to meet the incredible demand, and there were a significant number of non-emergency 000 calls.
And of course, once they get into the system, they jam the system up.
You've got to remember this November when you vote and make sure you get rid of the worst government for 000 here in our state.
The government is acting on all of the report's recommendations, such as increasing Esther staff and funding. 93% of calls are now being answered on time.
The Esther today is not the same as the Esther 6 months ago. It's stronger.
There are questions being asked as to why such a significant report was handed down on a weekend and why the Premier wasn't in attendance. Minister Symes says responding to this review is her responsibility.
So that no one else goes through what we did. I mean, it's been 10 months, but every day we go through, we remember what happened that night.
Emily Rice, Nine News.